She ended up richer than the queen. She produced an empire that the value of it, I think, exceeded $40 billion. She got tens of thousands of young people to read 600-page books, and she did readings in stadiums. And that just doesn't even scrape the surface with regards to the movies. And now she has a play on Broadway that's killing it critically and generating all sorts of money there too. So, and I see that too in the, like, people are, what? There seems to be an inexhaustible hunger for superhero movies. You know, in the latest one, I mean, I think the Marvel people did a very good job with their superhero enterprise. Some of those stories, maybe I'll analyze them in videos at some point, but even the last one, I mean, Thanatos, who is the major figure of evil, is really an environmentalist gone mad, you know, because he thinks there's too many people on the planet, so to speak, and his goal is, well, we'll just eradicate half of them and everyone will be better off. And there's a spirit of death, in some sense, that inhabits our culture that's very anti-human in its fundamental nature, that has exactly that idea. And so you can't kill the mythology, right? It comes back in full force in all sorts of strange places. All the atheistic engineers are geeked out over Star Wars. It's like, well, it's because you're getting your religion in this narrative form. You don't even notice it, and that's why it grips you so well. You don't notice that what you're doing, so you believe. It's so interesting to see. So, all right. Well, thank you. That was a pleasure.